So Leyte Omnes, today we're looking at 201 to, not 207, 227 of Book 2. This is the infamous Serpentes. All right. Leocoan ductus Neptuno. So ductus, oh yeah, sorry. So Lacoan, we put ductus goes to Lacoan or Sicardo. So having been selected as a Sicardo, as a priest by, a priest for Neptune by lot. Okay? And setting the scene of the thing. Was sacrificing at the solemn altars a ingentum parum, a great bowl, or near the altars. Ecce autem. Whenever you see ecce autem in Virgil, I like to think of it as being like a watch out here. Behold, ecce. Gemini. Twin. And where's Gemini going with? Oh, anguines. Anguines. So twin. That's very, so far separation. Twin serpents from Tenda, so from the nearby island. This, of course, is where the Greeks are right now. Through the tranquil waters, or the tranquil deep. And this is Aeneas speaking. Horisco, I shudder, recalling. This is P-A-P. It means reporting, recalling, telling. With immense coils, literally immense orbs. Okay? And then, so these twin snakes, incumbent, and we've seen this several times, recline upon the sea, and pariter, and equally, or side by side, is another way to do it. Par equal, it's the idea of being, there's two snakes, and they're equally hurrying, or going, or stretching, ad litera, to the shores. Oh boy, we have these twin snakes. All right, so the twin sea serpents are coming towards the shore, and they're going to do something with Lacoan here, okay? Now, quorum here is connective relative. It's very similar to like what you get in Caesar. What you could say with it is like there, okay? Their pectora, okay? Their raised chests. Between the waves, or the chest raised between the waves, fluctus, and their bloody, sanguinei, like blood red, I would say blood red crests. These snakes have like crests on their head. Overcome the waves. So they're above the waves, all right? Their chests are raised up, all right? One part, so a certain part of the snake from behind. Skims. It's like literally reeds. It means they're going closely upon the pontem. Alright? And they twist. They sinuate. What a great word. Sinuate. They twist their backs. Their immensa terga. Their immense backs in a coil. Now this is voluminae, where we get volume from. So think of a book volume. So remember, an ancient Roman book be a scroll, and you look like, we look on it not the straight way, not looking at it like this, where it's rolled out, you're looking at it, it's all turned together, you're looking at the side, you can see the coils going, isn't that great? And then a fit sonia spumante salo. Thus a sound happened with the frothing salt. Salt, okay, salt, of course, metonymy, sea. And now they held the lands. So now they're suddenly on the lands. And what are they going to do? Oh boy. And ardentesque oculos. Okay, and having suffecti, having suffused. Now suffecti here is PPP from sufficio. It's taking a accusative, like a body part or accusative of respect, we could call it. Okay, having filled their burning eyes with blood and fire, and they lament and they licked their hissing mouths with their vibrating tongues. Oh man, that's so good. All right, this is horrible. And now we finally get Aeneas' perspective. De fugimus, we ran away. Exsanguine, so blood out, mean pale. And it's describing there, so pale by the sight. Okay? Ile, those snakes, petunt, sought Leocalon with a certain line. Think of a column, certain column. So think of like an army, okay? And first, we'll move it up here a little bit. Not so good. Okay. And first, what do they do? Where's our subject here? So we go serpents is our subject, okay? Utraque, eat serpent first, having embraced. This is a perfect participle of a deponent verb. Having embraced the small bodies of the two sons, okay? Each snake having embraced the two bodies of the twin sons. So they attack, so they start encircling Lacawan's children, and they implicat, they fold them, they twist, they surround. And they depascitur, we've seen this referring to the deer, but when you refer to deer feeding on the grass, this is a little bit more, it's not so good. And they feed upon the miserable limbs with a bite. All right. Afterwards, okay, they do what? We have accusative, looks like we have a PAP. We have another PAP going with ipsum. Okay. Oops, so that's accusative, sorry. Ablative, or that's a dative actually, dative of purpose, what's going on. And then forentimes, nice PAP. And they corripuant, and they seized afterwards, they seized ipsum Lacawan himself, coming to help and bearing weapons. And they ligant, and they bound him with great coils. And now, what they do? Bis medius implexi, having embraced. Again, we have implexi, complexi, implexi. Having now embraced twice around the middle. Okay? Perfect participle, deponent. Twice having given, and now this is a PPP again, taking the cues of respect, having given their scaly backs around twice in respect to his, his neck. Oh no, they conquered his neck, we could say. So having given their scaly backs, or having given twice their scaly backs around on his neck, they overcome his head and with his high necks. We're going to say high neck. Oh. All right. And then so we have, there's going after him. All right. And that man, same time, tendon. Now, tendon, of course, means stretch, but it can also mean strive or try. Tries to rip apart the knots with his hands. Having stained his garlands with gore and dark venom. Okay? At the same time, he raises horrible shouts to the stars. Qualis mugitus, such bellowing. And bellowing, of course, here, this is like mooing, really. It has the idea of mooing. So, such bellowing. When, this is a horrible image, very horrible. I did not like this at all. When a wounded Saucius Taurus fugit, flees an altar and excusit, think of percusit, excusit, concusit, shakes off the uncertain axe from the neck. So it's just like when, and this is a weird I-stem accusative, so it's just like when a sacrifice goes wrong. Oof, bad image. Okay? But the snakes, with their gliding, the twin snakes, okay, Draconis, getting that together, with they're going to go to the tops of the shrines, they flee, and they seek the citadel of savage Draconis, and are covered under, so they go up to the shrine of Minerva. So this also kind of gives the image of like, this is Minerva, so this is okay. And they are covered under the feet of the goddess and under the circle of her shield. So Lacaon is eaten, his sons are killed, and the snakes go up to the citadel of Troy. What an image. All right. Valete omnes lingua latina est vita.